about 10 of us, I had a Barney Fife type of officer put my handcuffs on. So immediately, I took them off once I was in the paddy wagon and took pictures of Carl, took pictures of Cornell and everybody else in that paddy wagon. And once we got to the 28th precinct, they didn't take my camera phone away. So I took pictures of everybody behind bars, put them on Facebook within 5 minutes before they yanked my camera. And the New York Times ran them on their Twitter account, I believe. You guys can't be smoking while I'm up here. I've been up here for like 4 fucking hours, man. I'm tired. I'm like Lawrence of Arabia that walked the fucking Aqaba, man. I'm thirsty. I'm tired. This is not fair, people walking out. Carl, that was funny. Craft some funny shit, man. No, at any rate, I'm going to be back. Carl, you know, I'm going out of town to my brother-in-law's funeral on Saturday. That's true. I'm coming back Monday night on the red eye. Be here Tuesday morning to be arrested in Brooklyn at 4 o'clock on Tuesday. I will be there. And I want anyone that's in this room to go down there, get arrested, be in a cell with Cornel West, man. Gee, and Carl Dix, it's a blast. Talk about Theodore Parker, Emerson, Thoreau, you know, all these characters, Whittier, Thomas Wentworth Higginson. I'll name drop some other abolitionists if you'd like me to. That's why I look like I'm an intellectual. All right, folks. Thomas Crown Affair, no, the Anthony Burns. Anthony Burns. We're all here. These are the three guys I hang out with at Occupy Wall Street. These three clowns here, all right? They're the funniest guys I know. Tom, Dan, and Justin. They've been there every single day. We have a blast. We're able to make fun of people inside the park without any repercussions. You know, some people are very serious inside. I dropped I dropped a cap on the ground. Like about 20 yards later, somebody says, "You dropped this." You know, I dropped a toothpick on the ground. I was like in the subway. Somebody came over to the subway 4 blocks away. "You dropped this toothpick in the park."
We got a DNA sample.
Yes. I got a DAT, you know, from the police that occupied Wall Street. All right, so we have a lot more comedy. We have few women coming on back to back. Then we have somebody from the Libertarian Party who's going to be speaking, who's running for office, to show you the other side. We have Leanne Lord. We have you coming up right now. And we know, I'm starting to like, I sound like Bob Novak from Crossfire. Mr. Critical, isn't it true that you're really a communist? I'm going to shit my mouth or garble, you know. All right, at any rate, we have a lot more comedy. And people, once they perform, I don't want them to leave. I got to have a crowd. I got people with cameras in here, and it looks very selfish to perform and just beeline out of here, okay?
Where do we donate?
I'm going to pass a hat right now because I got to pay some. I'm way in a hole here. One guy got to get back to LaGuardia Airport in the morning. Another guy, I had to get back to Bath, New York. So anyone that's got a few bucks they can spare, please just give it to me. I'm in for 100. I got 100 in my pocket that I'm donating, okay, out of my own measly bank account. I drew everything I had in Chase before I got arrested there. My last 100 that I'm giving away. So on behalf of God, I'm asking you to make a contribution to the people that have to drive all the way back. We need some cash. Help me drill for diamonds inside Liberia. We've got to go to Venezuela, get rid of that man with a hurt. Any way we can get rid of that man, take our gold and oil that we've got under his ground, somehow slipped away from Louisiana under Hugo Chavez's ground there. I don't know how it got there. We got to get it back. It slipped away. It prolapsed, whatever the fucking word is. But Jesus, help us get those assets back. We need it, but tonight I just need to raise a 10 or 20 for everybody in the room. It'd be nice if he does that laugh. If he's so close to God, how come God doesn't fix that friggin' neck of his? They accused him of anti-Semitism. He said, I'm not an anti-Semite. These are scurrilous words being spread by Jews. All right, folks, we got a lot more show. I'll be here until 4 o'clock in the morning.
I'll send 8 o'clock in you.
8 o'clock. I know no one's gonna be here at 8 o'clock anyway, except for the police. All right, that's it. The NYPD. They got the detail. 4 o'clock and shut this fucking place down. And I'll be like that Marine in Oakland. I don't want to be that guy. All right.
No way.
All right. So folks, we'll be talking about a lot of issues. I'm gonna pass the hat. No, wait. I got something better before I bring up. I'm gonna pass the Madoff mask.
Yes.
This is the Madoff mask. I've been out there saying I was the scapegoat. It's all a Ponzi scheme. So help me with the Ponzi scheme of tonight's comedy show, which once again, I put a lot of time into it and didn't make a fucking dime.
All right,
so now we're going to bring up we have a slew of comedians. That's like passe comedian, right? You say comedian, that's all, right? Comic, just say comic. You don't say comica. In Nicaragua, we'd say cómica. It wouldn't be sexist, all right? Entonces, vamos a traer acá a hablar con mis amigos, la comediante de el burro de Queens, la reina, burro de reina. You're really tired. You got to get back to March at 6 in the morning. Please welcome Laura D.
I know you guys don't have a fucking nickel to your name.
Randy, thank you so much. I am heating up in this fur. Yes, I am hot in this fur. I am a liberal. I was waiting for Peter to come down, babe. No, it is not real fur, but I am a liberal who eats meat. And pussy at one point, because I thought I was bisexual, but I was just drunk. I not only want to take back Wall Street, I also want to take back Brooklyn. I grew up here. I got suspended from the sixth grade for punching a Puerto Rican in the face. I want to take back Brooklyn from all the obnoxious yuppies who lied to get into Brown. I grew up there, so this is from my one-woman show.
In Brown?
How brown is it? Brown, Emerson, wherever they got into. New York without the human touch, without the gravity of dirt and smut and porn and art, is nothing but chaos and a bad train system. The beauty struggles to stay, but it's being choked by all the chubby girls who write blogs. New York has turned into one big shopping mall sprinkled with girls who write blogs, and they wear clothes that outshine even trees. Silver sandals like they auditioned for Fahrenheit 451, with a hypnotized smile waiting to be gassed to death by Beyonce. We're all gonna have to wrestle the chubby girls who write blogs and are addicted to Pringles potato chips for the moon. Because Earth is going stale before our eyes. We have lost the glow of identity. Real life has been replaced by a sexy virtual one, an electric world that stalls on purpose to let us live. We are out of print. Paper is as ancient as China, and so is flesh. Facebook pities you. It bides its time until a digital hitman opens your door, pisses in your bathroom, and fucks your wife. I am just a shadow waiting for that blue cartoon to blow me away, waiting for the future to snuff my legacy. My name's Laura Dinabil. Thank you very much.
All right.
Randy Credico, fantastic comic. I could watch Randy for 4 hours up here with this Ponzi scheme. Thank you.
Laura D. Now we have someone from sanitation. Are you still here? Sanitation. Where's the, sanitation?
That would be my department. To someone work in sanitation. With I think the Luzzati family. Or the Italia family. for sanitation on this day of my daughter's wedding is going to make an announcement about the cleanliness. How do we ever get in this mess? Natalia, Nino Barzini, they all made a mess out of this, out of that park. They all, with the drugs, it's a dirty business. But, until today, I am, on the soul of my grandson, I will keep the peace.
All right.
Sanitation.
How y'all doing? I'm Murdoch. I'm with Sanitation at Occupy Wall Street. This place here is acting as a drop-off point. We need large garbage bags. We had people come and snap our brooms at the dead of night. Yes, it's happening. So if you have brooms, if you have, you know, large garbage bags, paper towels, you know, that was a request from the kitchen and sanitation. Yippie Cafe is holding that, and I come by every 2 days, and I pick it up, and I bring it down to the sanitation department. That was my public service announcement, and now he's gone. You know, like, yeah, it's amazing how this works. Oh, fuck, I'll tell you the fuck I am. My name's John Murdoch. I work over at Lucky Chang's Drag Restaurant as the only non-drag act, number one. Yeah, no, this is how I go to work, like this. Yeah.
You protest too soon.
What's that? I protest too soon? Yeah, at times. With that, have you ever met the drag queens around 4 or 5 in the morning? You know,
yeah, it might be.
Well, yeah, a lot of people have. At least you admit it. You know, most people. We get more fucking Hasids, actually.
Yeah.
They love us. You know, because, like, you know, it's the way station between gay. It's not quite gay, but it's, yeah, but it's, you know, gay enough. You know, they're there for the karaoke and like the hard stare down. They love that. That shit. I got started actually, you know, because there were a couple magazine articles that got me in. I was in FHM making a balloon bikini, which was a great day. I actually made it on the model. It was her first job in New York City, you know, and like it's like welcome to New York. Here's a pervert with balloons, and she didn't speak the fucking word. She still doesn't know what the fuck happened that day. Time Out magazine. I made a life-size Santa Claus out of balloons with his pants down and an elf whipping his bare ass. And my parents didn't know what the content was, and they went and told all their friends, like, my son is going to be in Time Out magazine. You know, because when your son is a balloon man, you don't get to brag that often, you know. So they didn't know, though. It came back at me in that the title was Blowjob with my face like this. I was the blowjob guy. I know. And then it was I was in Playgirl magazine, which was weird. That led to nothing. That just led to like two guys emailing me saying, I'm having a party by myself with my partner. We would like you to come. And like that was how it was written. It was like, you know, but my parents wanted to support me. So my dad went into like a sketchy bodega in Philly, and he was trying to buy the fucking Playgirl. And he went up to the bodega guy with his hands like shaking with the Playgirl on his hand, and he freaking panicked, and he looked at the guy and he goes, my son's in it! Because in his mind, that made it better. Yeah, which was messed up. It's not just the glory of making dirty things out of balloons. I was a licensed tour guide in New York City on the double-decker buses. And yeah, I was here during the Republican convention. And, oh yeah. You know, and you know, working a drag restaurant, dirty liberal comic. It got nasty. It got ugly because all the older tour guides, they peaced out. You know, because they didn't want to deal with that shit. So they left it to like the newbies, which was me. You know, and like I'm used to talking shit. You know, like there's a reason I'm over at Lucky Chang's, and like I don't like children. You know, I guess that's just I really don't. I like it if you're an asshole. I'm gonna describe the temperature and fucking degree of cleanliness of your asshole, you know, and that is the freedom that Chang's gives me. But I got a lot of arguments. There are a group of people at the Republican convention, and they want to put Ronald Reagan on a monument on Mount Rushmore. They literally want to do that, which blew my mind. And like on the bus, I said that is misguided. Ronald Reagan already has a monument. It's called the AIDS Quilt, and one should never ever be mentioned without the other. They should go down in history together because that was genocide. I did not get tipped on that tour at all. They did not like that much at all. But what was that convention about? But you know, photo ops, you know. They had to have the photo ops. Like, what? Like, everything was like ground zero. It's like, is that ground zero? I'm like, we're in Harlem, and those are buildings. That's not a hole. You know, like, you know, clearly we are not at ground zero. You know?